Creatine is one of the most well-researched supplements out there. I take it every day, as do several other fitness buffs, so let's talk about it for a few minutes. What is it? Creatine is a molecule produced in the body that plays a role in energy production via donating a phosphate group to ADP, allowing it to become ATP. It's produced in the body, primarily in the liver and kidneys, but also the pancreas, at a rate of roughly 1 gram per day, and it's stored predominantly in the muscle. In foods, it can be found in meat and fish. And yes, this does mean that vegans will have lower resting concentrations of creatine. Supplementing with exogenous creatine can increase your levels by 20 to 40%, as you can see in this graph. Okay, great, but what does it do? Creatine has been found to increase exercise performance and is especially recommended for strength and power athletes. Following creatine loading, high intensity and repetitive exercise performance can increase by 10 to 20%. Check out this list of the many performance enhancing benefits of creatine supplementation. These benefits have been shown in adolescents, younger adults, older adults, and in both men and women. Further, it's been shown to enhance recovery by maintaining optimal glycogen levels, reducing muscle damage, increasing tolerance to high volumes of training, and more. What about them muscle gains? For resistance training individuals, creatine supplementation can help increase muscle mass. Here's a graph from a study on 25 football players after 4 weeks of creatine supplementation. As you can see, the creatine group shown in teal experienced a significantly greater increase in lean body mass compared to the placebo group. But wait, there's more. Did you know that creatine has cognitive benefits too? Supplementing with creatine can increase creatine content in the brain by 5 to 15%. This can help improve working memory, increase cognitive function, reduce mental fatigue, and also improve cognitive performance in response to sleep deprivation. Also, during pregnancy, creatine supplementation has been found to promote fetal growth, development, and health. In aging individuals, it can help lower cholesterol and triglyceride levels, reduce fat accumulation in the liver, enhance glycemic control, minimize bone loss, and more. Whew! There's actually quite a bit more, but for the sake of not dragging out this video, I'll end this section here. Okay, what about non-responders? You may have heard about non-responders to creatine supplementation. This simply means that some people don't experience the benefits I just went over. From the studies I've read, roughly 20 to 30% of people are non-responders to creatine. Check out this study from 2004. You'll see here that the participants in purple saw little to no changes in their intramuscular creatine content after 5 days of creatine loading. Unfortunately, there is no easy way to test for this besides simply taking creatine, more on this later, and seeing if you notice the positive changes over time. By the way, responders are those who have lower resting initial levels of total muscle creatine content, greater type 2 fibers, and higher potential to improve performance in response to creatine supplementation. That means that non-responders will be the opposite. And before you get upset, before you find out that you're a non-responder, think of it this way. It means you already have higher resting total muscle creatine content levels to begin with, so you don't need to supplement. Now you may want to know, is it safe? To date, there have been over 1,000 studies on creatine conducted in infants to the elderly at doses ranging from 0.3 to 0.8 grams per kilogram of body weight per day for up to 5 years. The research has consistently shown that there are zero adverse health risks and a plethora of performance and health benefits. And despite anecdotal claims, there has been no research demonstrating an increased risk of musculoskeletal injuries, dehydration, muscle cramping, GI upset, or renal dysfunction. The only consistently reported side effect in some individuals is weight gain due to water retention and protein and/or glycogen accretion. But don't let this stop you from taking creatine. It is not body fat. So the answer is yes, supplementing with creatine is safe in healthy individuals of all ages. How do I take it? There are two primary ways to take creatine. The first is creatine loading, which saturates your body's creatine levels a lot quicker. This entails ingesting 0.3 grams per kilogram of body weight per day, split into 4 to 5 daily intakes for 5 to 7 days. After that, you can drop your intake down to 0.03 grams per kilogram of body weight per day indefinitely. Without the loading phase, it may take 3 to 4 weeks to increase your muscle's creatine stores. According to the ISSN position stand from 2017, you can simply take 3 to 5 grams per day indefinitely. Also, taking your creatine supplement with a carb or a carb and protein seems to increase your muscular uptake of creatine, so maybe take it with a meal. When should I take it? In a 2013 study on healthy young male bodybuilders, taking creatine immediately post-workout as opposed to immediately pre-workout was found to be possibly more beneficial. If you look at this graph here, which shows the participants' changes between the two groups over a 4 week period, the post-workout slope is ever so slightly greater. The authors thus concluded that taking creatine post-workout may be superior in terms of fat-free mass gains. The next year, another study was conducted, this time on adults between ages 50 to 64. By the end of this 12-week intervention, there was no difference in lean body mass or strength changes in those who took creatine immediately before versus immediately after their training session. Then another study looked at creatine taken immediately pre and post-workout compared to morning and then late evening. After 10 weeks, the first group taking creatine immediately before and immediately after their workout led to significantly greater intramuscular creatine content, lean tissue mass, and muscle cross-sectional area of type 2 fibers. And then there was this meta-analysis, albeit in only 3 studies, from 2018 that found a slight edge on taking creatine post-workout. So this is what the research says is optimal, but I'm gonna throw in my 2 cents. Successfully taking creatine regularly is more important than splitting hairs over the timing. If you're more likely to take your creatine consistently at a certain time of day that is not pre or post-workout, then do it. Given all the benefits that creatine has to offer, I think it's safe to say that taking creatine daily, regardless of timing, is going to be more beneficial than not taking it at all. What brand should I take? The only supplement company I trust and recommend is PEScience. I am sponsored by them, full disclosure. They carry creatine in 2 forms. This is the capsule form, which is what I take. Here's what it looks like in my hand. And they also have a powdered form, which you can mix with water or blend it in with your protein shake. You can use my code SOHEFIT to get 15% off. That's all for today's video on creatine. I hope you guys learned a lot. Please leave your questions in the comment section below. I will answer them to the best of my ability. Thanks for tuning in.